Ugandans encouraged to engage in Insurance Week that closes this week in Kampala. Rwanda taxi firm Yego stars Kenya's market. South Sudan to get $114.8 million IMF fund. And fresh fuel crisis looms in Kenya. It's always an amazing conversation to listen to anything that can ease operations in business. And that is probably something that will sit here and tell you if it can be, then the business community will be able to benefit. So some of the stories topping up the headlines across the region is that the recent fuel crisis could loom or is already looming again in Kenya. And this is something that will somehow just cause worries for us. We'll be talking about what that means for the business world and also generally what impact that then translates down to Uganda. My name is Simon. Thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. This is what's coming up tonight.
Small business owner out there, please, it's extremely a very important issue to understand the finances of your business. How do you do this? First and foremost, aim at keeping accurate books of accounts. As a small business owner, you also need to track and frequently review your financial statements. When the business starts growing and the transactions become complex, then there, I think it's incumbent upon you as a small business owner to hire services of a qualified accountant.
Once again, welcome to the show, and this week we'll start with leveraging technology to boost financial freedom. Now, how many of you wouldn't want to be able to move into any platform of saving and put your money and get it at some interest rate that can allow you then reinvest it or even start a business at a fairly, you know, interest rate compared to the other 22, 23 and above that the banks charge? Now, if an individual is able to have financial freedom, they'll be definitely be able to choose where they want to invest their money, how much they want to borrow at, and how much they want to pay as interest. The unlikely, you know, state though for Uganda is that there's limited platforms that can offer you a rate where you're able to bargain the interest. And this is probably one of the reasons why guys in the tech world are trying to ensure that SACCOs get a bigger platform to ensure that more Ugandans can think about saving through SACCOs. And it is not just a saving through SACCOs, but if they can use technology to save, borrow and repay, then that will definitely inform what we call financial freedom. This week, Views from the Top speak to Vincent, who is the CEO of FutureLink, and we're talking just how far and what freedom does financial freedom bring in the growth of the economy. Views from the Top.
Vincent Mwejucha is my name, CEO of FutureLink Technologies. You know, when you talk about technology and particularly financial inclusion, we are talking about the ability of everyone to be able to participate in an equitable financial system. That means that everyone is able to afford financial services, everyone is able to afford the capital to be able to do business. It is an inclusive system, not only just access, but also the ability of the people to participate in this financial system. And that is what we call really financial inclusion. So 2023 is, in my view, a year of hope. Because from COVID and now 2023, you are able to see people beginning to go back to their lives, beginning to dream big, and that's where now technology comes in, because we perceive that technology is able to play a key role in Africa to be able to mobilize capital. One of the challenges of Africa is the inability to access capital to do business. And by capital, we are not talking about, you know, so many millions. We are talking about even just 100,000 for this mama in the market. They literally have to borrow money to do everything. So we see technology as a tool to be able to mobilize capital, and particularly to mobilize savings of a country. You see, that 100,000 of this mama is not able to do so much if it remains alone. But think about these million people being able to generate 100,000 each, you know, if they have saved for a year. 100,000 means 10 billion. Now, 10 billion can cause really great transformation. And you know, you can lend it to a few mamas and they are able to do this, and as they pay back, the money is able to be lent to other people. And that activity in itself unlocks further funding for capital, because there are stakeholders out of the country who are literally just looking for the demonstration of capacity to be able to pay back. So I see that technology becomes really a very key role to mobilize capital for people's lives to move on. You see, and this is very, very important. Technology in itself is not able to transform lives unless there is a clear intent to actually change the system to work for everyone. And this is where M-Circle comes in. We have positioned M-Circle as a tool for financial freedom. How does that happen? The fact that you are able to actually access financial services that are provided by hundreds of circles on one platform, you are able to see how much interest rate is given out for this particular loan, this particular circle, and you are able to choose which circle actually best suits you. You are able to choose your community, and then, you know, be able to access financial services. We have been able to see now a movement of people realizing that actually by my choice, I can begin to influence how financial services are priced, how financial services are designed, how they are delivered to the communities. And this is really what M-Circle is actually doing. Let me also mention that I am part of one of the circles that has been able to lend for the last 1 year at 9.75% per annum. Now they have just increased the rate to 10% per annum, not per month. Sometimes when we talk about these rates and we don't add the frequency, people get confused. 10% per annum means less than 1% per month. And the same circle has been able to pay interest on savings of 16.5% as of just last month. How do they do it? They have improved efficiency. So the money that they spend on administration is so small. And then they are saving, they have agreed themselves, you know, they have agreed amongst themselves that we shall save and not withdraw the savings. So the circle is at liberty now to invest in long-term projects without having the fear that the money is going to be demanded tomorrow. And so you are able to get a decent return, a more decent return. This is better than NSSF. And this is what we are calling financial freedom, to have the people participate in the design of financial services, they themselves, but also to mention that when you bank with a circle, the money remains with the communities. At the end of the financial year, when these dividends are actually shared, the dividends remain within the communities. So you are able to have a compounding effect of communities being able to build their lives upward. And so this is how far M-Circle is doing. And we are happy to see really the progress. Yes. So ultimately, growth and economic growth can only happen when the people's dignity has been recovered. That is when, you know, that self-confidence to know that I have the ability to make informed choice is the beginning of transformation. And so for that alone, M-Circle enables people to actually choose, make informed choice. But think about it. When you want to get financial services and you go to a bank, they will give you only a brochure that talks about their services. But just imagine if you had the ability to look at five brochures at the same time, not once in a year when they publish these in the papers, but that you have a need now and you are able to see the terms and conditions and compare, and you have a system to help you make an informed choice. And this is the kind of transformation. And then we go back, we come back, and then come back to the financial cooperatives, the circles, and tell them, you see, 1,000 people came to you and about 97% turned away, and we think this is the problem. Are you willing to actually adjust so that you are more responsive to the needs of your customers, to the needs of the communities? So we improve on one side, the circles to offer a better service, but also ensuring that the end consumer is empowered to continuously influence the design, the delivery, the pricing of financial services. And that is what we are calling financial freedom. Yes. I think that, you know, sessions like this, the media, as you are doing, you are playing a very critical role to raise awareness of the possibilities of cooperatives. Because, you know, a cooperative is an aggregated voice of how people would like to be treated, how people would like to be served. And that amplification, what you are doing right now, you are amplifying the voice of communities to be able to come together. There is power in coming together, and that is the voice that needs to actually happen and be amplified. But also, more importantly, to look into corporate governance. Because for you to be able to use technology, because technology is a tool of scale. So if you have something, technology can scale it. But if you do not, for that to happen, you must have accountability mechanisms in place. And this is what we do with the circles. We do not only, you know, provide technology, but journey with them to develop policies that enhance accountability, that enhance governance, that enhance confidence in the institution, so that the institution is able to attract both the customer, but also other stakeholders that are important for their growth.
So this is probably an interesting conversation that Vincent loves, because look, it is only obvious that when people know what they want to do with their money and where they want to put it, then it translates somehow into direct growth of the economy. Being limited or curtailed by high interest rates limit your abilities to invest and also choose options where to save your money. So we can hope that people start looking at circles as not just a platform where there is a group of people, let's say in the neighborhood or in a trading center, but rather a platform where you can save away from that district, but still get your money without physically meeting the people. And that's probably, one of the things that, you know, the platform M-Circle is trying to address. For you to be able to choose an interest rate that works for you, a group that works for you, and ensure that this helps you access money whenever you want it, but also at a rate that you determine, you know, depending on the next annual general meeting, since you're a member of the association. You're watching The Business Show with me, Simon Tao. Now for a quick break. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us. Tell us what you think about the show and also where you're watching from. We'll be glad to know. And probably there are topics that you love so much about business that you think you need to have addressed, it bookkeeping or, you know, records or anything, advertising, let us know. We'll be more than glad to help you. Let's take a break. I'll see you shortly.